The romance fizzled out. The couple's marriage license expired in February 2015 amid tabloid rumors that Burton wanted to marry the killer so that she could put his body on display for profit after his death, a claim her parents later denied. Whatever Burton's reasons for pursuing the relationship, when news broke about the pair's engagement, the internet couldn't stop talking about the sexual phenomenon called hybristophilia or, as it's sometimes called, Bonnie and Clyde syndrome. But hybristophilia isn't always what drives women and men to feel an attraction to killers. In fact, Ramsland told HuffPost it's rarely to blame. In 1989, Richard Ramirez, aka the Night Stalker, was sentenced to death on charges that included 13 murders, 5 attempted murders, and 11 sexual assaults. That didn't deter freelance magazine editor Doreen Lyoy from marrying him 7 years later. She called him kind, funny and charming. While there's no one-size-fits-all profile for the type of women who would fall for a serial killer, they've usually experienced troubled childhoods, said Sheila Eisenberg, an English professor and the author of Women Who Love Men Who Kill. Without exception, the women I interviewed for my book had all been involved in early abusive relationships, Eisenberg said. Their families, first boyfriends, husbands, or someone else had abused them either sexually, physically, emotionally. According to Eisenberg, getting involved with an imprisoned criminal gives the women some semblance of power. It's a chance to be in control, often for the first time in their lives, Eisenberg told HuffPost. They make the decisions, they are the ones with the freedom to come and go. It may seem counterintuitive, but becoming involved with a violent convicted murderer feels safe for a woman who's had an abusive past, the writer said. He's behind bars, she's not. In some ways, the convicted criminal is the perfect boyfriend for these women, Ramsland added. The woman knows where he is at all times, and while she can now claim that someone loves her, she does not have to endure the day-to-day issues of most relationships, she said. She can keep the fantasy charged up for a long time, without having to cook, clean or report in to someone. That fantasy often includes the belief that only they know what their boyfriend is really like, said Oren Amidai, a Toronto-based psychologist. Many of these women believe they are the only one who can reach the real person underneath the monster being falsely portrayed, Amidai said. Only they can give their boyfriend the love and support he deserves, reveal his true self and prove that he's innocent, or at least misunderstood, to the public. Still, the desire for fame cannot be underestimated, Ramsland said. If you're looking for quick celebrity status, dating a convicted murderer will get you that. These people go on talk shows to proclaim their love and insist that the convicted murderer got a raw deal or is different now, she added. They may even take credit for reforming him, as if their love was all he needed to change, the magical ingredient. In cases of death sentences, the women's part of the story continues after their partner is gone. As for Burton, in January, her parents claimed she tried to see Manson while he was severely ill but was thwarted by the hospital. In her father's words, the former couple were still friends.